गुरुरेव गतिर् गुरुमेव भजे गुरुणैव सहास्मि नमो गुरवे न गुरोः परमं शिशुरस्मि गुरोः मतिरस्ति गुरौ मम पाहि गुरो। ओके सो यस्टर्डे वी dealt with the basic rules of pronunciation in Sanskritam. What you see on this screen here is Varnamala or Varnaha, that is the garland of letters in Sanskritam. We have Swaraha, which are vowels, and Hrasva Swaraha, Dirgha Swaraha, and Plutaha. Hrasvaha are the short vowels, A, I, U, R, and L. Dirghaha, long A, I, U, R, A, I, O, and AU. Like I said yesterday, please note A and I are always Dirghaha, long vowels in Sanskritam. We do not have their short versions. Plutaha are those vowels which take more time, which are longer than Dirghaswaraha. But we do not come across that here in this particular text, in this stotra. Then we have Ayogavahaha, which are Anuswaraha, the dot above, that is the Anuswara. The pronunciation would be or say Ramam, Devim, that in the end. Visargaha, Aha, like Ramaha, Krishnaha. Jihvamuliyaha, whenever a Visarga is followed by Ka or Kha, then we get the Jishvamulia pronunciation. For example, Antahkaranam becomes Antahkaranam. So the Visarga is not chanted completely. Then Upadhmaniyaha, when a Visarga is followed by Pa or Pa. For example, Naguroho Paramam, we chant it as Nagurof Paramam. We don't chant the Visarga completely. That is Upadhmaniya. Coming to the consonants, the Vyanjanani, two main types. There are many other types also. Mainly two types, Vargiya, Avargiya, as the name suggests, Vargiya, grouped consonants, Avargiya, non-grouped consonants. Vargiya, we have five Vargaha, five groups, Ka Vargaha, Cha Vargaha, Ta Vargaha, Ta Vargaha, and Pa Vargaha. In each group, we have five, Ka Kha, Ga Gha, Nga. So, Ka Ga, if you note the pronunciation, you require less breath. They are called Alpapranaha. Kha, Gha, you require more breath, Mahapranaha. Nga, Anunasikaksharam, that is, you require the help of the nose to pronounce it. Anunasika, so Nga. Next Varga, Cha, Cha, Ja, Jha, Nya. Ta, Tha, Da, Dha, Na. Ta, Tha, Da, Dha, Na. Pa, Pha, Ba, Bha, Ma. So I hope the pronunciation is clear. Avargiya Vyanjanani are non-grouped consonants. We have Ya, Ra, La, Va, Sh, Sh, S, and H. We learned yesterday that we need to be careful about differentiating Sh, Sh, and S. So there is a difference in their pronunciation, which we will learn also with the verses. Then we also learned about Sanyuktaksharam, that is the combined letters. For example, here if you see this word, Sva, Sva, there is S, V, and A. Here, Varnaha, R and Na and Visarga in the end. So those also you need to be able to chant clearly whenever there are grouped letters or Sanyuktaksharan. Then we learned about certain rules pertaining to Anuswara. In the first verse, for example, Kartavyam Daivamanhikam. You could either chant the Anuswara completely as Kartavyam or Kartavyan Daivamanhikam. That is also, both are right. It's an optional rule whether you combine the Sandhi or you split the Sandhi and chant. We learnt about Dvitvam. As the name suggests, Dvi means two. Now, Dvitvam when do we say that we have a dvitvam there in the pronunciation? When you get a double letter pronunciation. So one example is suprabhatam. So here, though we do not have it is not su, p and pra, we do not have another p here, but when we chant or when we read, we chant it as suprabhatam with an other, with some stress before the pra. Before pra you get a stress, it is heard as a double p there, that is dvitvam, like suprabhatam. Similarly, supraja. And those who are familiar with the Gita, another example would be dharma kshetre, kurukshetre. So we do not say dharma kshetre, we say dharma kshetre. Similarly, it is not kurukshetre, it is kurukshetre. This is a very clear example of dvitvam there. You're in both the places, dharma kshetre, kurukshetre, you're getting that second k before the ksha. So that is an example also of dvitvam. So please do not get confused between mahaprana and dvitvam, as there was a question yesterday regarding this. They are two completely separate concepts. And as we go through the verses, you will get more familiar with each of these concepts. Just one more thing I would like to mention here. For those who are following in diacritics or in English, please note that this horizontal line above denotes a dirgha. So here, Kausalya, this A here, S-A, is a short letter. So that would be Kausal. But the last A here has a horizontal line above. So that denotes that it is a dirgha, that denotes it's a long letter. So it's Kausalya. Similarly, Supraja, please note the line above, horizontal line. Rama, Ra is dirgha, a long letter, therefore you have this horizontal line above. So this please note, because from past experience, a few of you who follow in diacritics tend to miss this dirgha part. So please be careful about that. And as we learn more, you will definitely be able to appreciate how these work. So we will begin with a quick recap of yesterday's verses. Kausalya supraja rama purva sandhya pravartate uttishthana rashardula kartavyam daivamanhikam uttishthottishtha govinda uttishtha garuda dhvaja uttishtha kamalakanta trailokyam mangalam kuru mata samasta jagatam madhukaita bharehe Vaksho Viharini Manohara Divya Murte Shri Swami Nishrita Janapriya Dana Shile Shri Venkatesha Daite Tava Suprabhatam. So this verse, Mataha Samasta Jagatam, pertains to Mother. Universal Mother, that is Padmavati Devi or Mahalakshmi hi. Mataha Samasta Jagatam, that is mother of the entire universe. And the next verse also pertains to Devi. Now we will learn the next verse. Vibha, ask you to please unmute and share your webcam. Vibha, are you here? I can't see you.
Ram Ram Ram.
Ah, Ram Ram, yes. Let us begin. तव सुप्रभातमरविन्दलोचने
तव सुप्रभातमरविन्दलोचने तव सुप्रभातमरविन्दलोचने
Okay, before we go to the next line, could I please request everyone else to please be on mute and to please switch off your video, because we have received many emails that there is some bandwidth issue and they are not able to hear the audio properly. Not everyone has very high speed internet, and there are more than 450 participants in class. So we have received a request if everyone else could please switch off their video so that you don't require as much bandwidth and everyone will be able to hear the audio properly. So request you to please do this. Please be on mute and switch off your videos, please. Tava suprabhatamaravindalochane
तव सुप्रभातमरविन्दलोचने तव सुप्रभातमरविन्दलोचने
भवतु प्रसन्नमुखचन्द्रमण्डले
भवतु प्रसन्नमुखचन्द्रमण्डले भवतु प्रसन्नमुखचन्द्रमण्डले
विधिशङ्करेन्द्रवनिताभिरर्चिते
विधिशङ्करेन्द्रवनिताभिरर्चिते विधिशङ्करेन्द्रवनिताभिरर्चिते
वृषशैलनाथदयिते दयानिधे
वृषशैलनाथदयिते दयानिधे वृषशैलनाथदयिते दयानिधे
Mom, let us see the Mahapranas here. Tava Suprabhatam. Bha is in Suprabhatam. Bha, always remember it's a Mahaprana. Bha here. Next line. Bhavatu Prasanna Mukha. Kha is a Mahaprana. Vidhi. Dha is Mahaprana. Here. Vanita Bhirarchite. Bhi is Mahaprana. वृषशैलनाथ थ इज अ महाप्राण दयानिधे धे इज अ महाप्राण हियर द द फर्स्ट द इज अल्पप्राण द लास्ट लेटर हियर धे दैट इज महाप्राण अगेन हियर द द्वित्वम तव सुप्रभातम देयर इज अ द्वित्वम हियर सुप्रभातम भवतु प्रसन्न सेकंड प इज हर्ड सो दैट इज आल्सो द्वित्वम भवतु प्रसन्न Yeah. So also please note some of the lines, like the third line, Vidhi Shankarendra Vanita Abhirarchite. So that is what we call a compound word, Samasta Padam. Many words combined together by virtue of their meaning. You also have a sandhi here, Vidhi Shankarendra Vanita Abhihi Archite, but we do not split, we chant together. So such lines, please chant in one breath. So initially some might feel that chanting in one breath might be a little difficult, but with practice in chanting, it definitely improves. So we have many of us who have told us from previous chanting classes that initially they could not hold their breath for one quarter also, but as they practiced, breath control improved so much and they were very easily able to do it. So it just comes with practice. Certain lines we will have to chant without taking a pause. And we will come across some verses where two lines will have to be chanted without taking a pause also. So even that is possible as you go on practicing. Tava suprabhata maravindalochane bhavatu prasanna mukha chandra mandale.
Tava suprabhata maravindalochane bhavatu prasanna mukha chandra mandale. Tava suprabhata maravindalochane bhavatu prasanna mukha chandra mandale.
Vidhi Shankarendra Vanita Bhirarchite Vrisha Shailanatha Daite Dayanidhe.
Vidhi Shankarendra Vanita Bhirarchite Vrisha Shailanatha Daite Dayanidhe. Vidhi Shankarendra Vanita Bhirarchite चिते वृष शैलनाथ दयिते दयानिधे.
उत्तमम्. नाउ द एंटायर वर्स. तव सुप्रभात अरविंद लोचने भवतु प्रसन्न मुख चंद्र मंडले विधि शंकरेन्द्र वनिताभिरर्चिते वृष शैलनाथ दयिते दयानिधे.
तव सुप्रभातमरविन्दलोचने भवतु प्रसन्न मुख चंद्र मंडले विधि शंकरेन्द्र वनिताभिरर्चिते वृष शैलनाथ दयिते दयानिधे.
उत्तमम्. लास्ट लाइन प्लीज सी नोट हियर. वृष शैल. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस इन प्रोनाउंसिएशन प्रोनाउंसिंग श एंड श. सो वृष एंड शैल हियर. शंकरेन्द्र श शिवः शंकरः. वेयर एज हियर इट इज वृष. इट इज वी यूज more of the tongue for pronouncing brisha compared to sha. So please note that slight difference in pronunciation. We will move to the next one. Shivani, request you to please share your webcam and unmute. And I once again request all those who are sharing your video to please stop sharing your video. It would benefit others because everyone doesn't have a very good bandwidth. So please help others by turning off your videos, please. It'll help them to listen to the audio better. Thank you. Shivani, idani anucharanam karoto. Atriyadi sapta rishaya samupasya sandhyam.
अत्र्यादि सप्त ऋषयः समुपास्य सन्ध्याम्. अत्र्यादि सप्त ऋषयः समुपास्य सन्ध्याम्.
आकाश सिंधु कमलानि मनोहराणि.
आकाश सिंधु कमलानि मनोहराणि. आकाश सिंधु कमलानि मनोहराणि.
आदाय पादयुगमर्चयितुं प्रपन्नाः.
आदाय पादयुगमर्चयितुं प्रपन्नाः. आदाय पादयुगमर्चयितुं प्रपन्नाः.
शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्.
शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्. प्रभातम् शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
So here, अत्र्यादि सप्त ऋषयः समुपास्य संध्याम्। So here, this is referring to Atri and other seven rishis here. We don't split this, we chant it together. Atriyadi Sapta Rishayas Samupasya Sandhyam. Here, Dha is Mahaprana. Akasha Sindhu. Here, Dha is again Mahaprana here. Akasha Sindhu Kamalani Manoharani. Ni is a Hrasva, that is a short letter. So please do not prolong it as Ni. And Adaya Pada Yuga Marchaitum Prapannaha. Sheshadri Shekhara. Kha is Mahaprana. Vibho. Bho is Mahaprana. Tava Suprabhatam. Bha is again Mahaprana here. So let us learn this again. As we are repeating, you all also could repeat along so that it would help you to familiarize yourself with the letters, with each letter and each word. Atriyadi saptarishaya samupasya sandhyam akasha sindhu kamalani manoharani
अत्र्यादि सप्त ऋषयः समुपास्य संध्याम् आकाश सिंधु कमलानि मनोहराणि अत्र्यादि सप्त ऋषयः समुपास्य संध्याम् आकाश सिंधु कमलानि मनोहराणि
आदाय पादयुगमर्चयितुं प्रपन्नाः शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
आदाय पादयुगमर्चयितुं प्रपन्नाः शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्। प्रभातम् आदाय पादयुगमर्चयितुं प्रपन्नाः शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
उत्तमम्। हियर आल्सो शेषाद्रिशेखर, सो वी हैव श एंड श. So there is a slight difference in pronunciation. Sheshadri Shekhara Vibho. Please note that difference while chanting. Now we will learn the entire verse. Any questions you could please type in the chat column, but I will be addressing them only towards the end of the class, please. Atriyadi Sap. तरिशयः समुपास्य संध्याम् आकाश सिंधु कमलानि मनोहराणि आदाय पादयुगमर्चयितुं प्रपन्नाः शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
अत्र्यादि सप्त ऋषयः समुपास्य संध्याम् आकाश सिंधु कमलानि मनोहराणि आदाय पादयुगमर्चयितुं प्रपन्नाः शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
उत्तमम्। इदानीं वी विल लर्न द नेक्स्ट वर्स। विभा पञ्चाननाब्जभवषण्मुखवासवाद्याः
पञ्चाननाब्जभवषण्मुखवासवाद्याः पञ्चाननाब्जभवषण्मुखवासवाद्याः त्रैविक्रमादिचरितम् त्रैविक्रमादिचरितम्
विबुधास्तुवन्ति
विबुधास्तुवन्ति विबुधास्तुवन्ति भाषापतिः पठति भाषापतिः पठति
वासरशुद्धिमारात्
वासरशुद्धिमारात् वासरशुद्धिमारात्
शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्
शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम् शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्
ओके पञ्चाननाब्ज भव भ इज महाप्राणा षण्मुख ख इज महाप्राणा हियर त्रैविक्रमादिचरितम् विबुधाः स्तुवन्ति ध इज महाप्राणा विबुधाः स्तुवन्ति हियर विसर्ग फॉलोड बाय स वी गेट व्हाट इज कॉल्ड अ विसर्ग सकार संधि सो इंस्टेड ऑफ द विसर्ग कंप्लीटली वी प्रोनाउंस एज विबुधास्तुवन्ति the second s comes in the place of the visarga so vibudhastuvanti bhashapatihi pathati bha is mahaprana here tha is also mahaprana visarga followed by pa we get what is called an upadhmaniya like we learnt yesterday so bhashapatihi pathati becomes bhashapati pathati the visarga is not chanted completely it is chanted as bhashapati pathati vasara shuddhi marat so here dha is again mahaprana then similarly the last line like I said last time in the last verse sheshadri shekhara kha is mahaprana vibho bha is mahaprana tava suprabhatam bha is again mahaprana so I hope that is clear just one request especially for those who are outside please switch off your video those who are walking outside etc please turn off your video because it is very distracting to others it also takes up more bandwidth thank you let us learn this verse again पञ्चाननाब्जभवषण्मुखवासवाद्याः त्रैविक्रमादिचरितं विबुधास्तुवन्ति
पञ्चाननाब्जभवषण्मुखवासवाद्याः त्रैविक्रमादिचरितं विबुधास्तुवन्ति पञ्चाननाब्जभवषण्मुखवासवाद्याः त्रैविक्रमादिचरितं विबुधास्तुवन्ति
भाषापतिः पठति वासरशुद्धिमारात् शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्
भाषापतिः पठति वासरशुद्धिमारात् शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्। भाषापतिः पठति वासरशुद्धिमारात् शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
Come on, now the entire verse. Panchananabja bhavashanmukhavasavadhyah Traivikramadi charitam vibudhastu vanti Bhashapati pathati vasarashuddhimarat Sheshadrishekhar vibho तव सुप्रभातम्।
पञ्चाननाब्ज भव षण्मुखवासवाद्याः त्रैविक्रमादिचरितं विबुधास्तुवन्ति भाषापतिः पठति वासरशुद्धिमारात् शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
उत्तमं विभा, धन्यवादाः। नेक्स्ट् शिवानी। ईषत् प्रफुल्ल सरसीरुह नारिकेल
ईषत् प्रफुल्ल सरसीरुह नारिकेल ईषत् प्रफुल्ल सरसीरुह नारिकेल
पूगद्रुमादि सुमनोहर
पूगद्रुमादि सुमनोहर पूगद्रुमादि सुमनोहर
पालिकानां
पालिकानां पालिकानां
आवाति मन्दमनिलस्सह
आवाति मन्दमनिलस्सह आवाति मन्दमनिलः सह
दिव्यगन्धैः
दिव्यगन्धैः दिव्यगन्धैः
शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम् शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
Here, ईषत् प्रफुल्ल, फ इज महाप्राण। प्लीज नोट दैट द फर्स्ट प हियर प्र दैट इज एन अल्प प्राण लेटर। द सेकंड वन फू Here, this is Mahaprana. So that has to be chanted perfectly without interchanging the Alpa Prana and the Mahaprana. Ishat Prafulla Sarasiruha Narikela Pugadrumadi Sumanohara Palikanam. So there are multiple words in this Samastapadam or compound word. I will repeat it once again. Ishat Prafulla Sarasiruha नारिकेल पूगद्रुमादि सुमनोहर पालिकानाम्। हियर पूगद्रुमादि द्वित्वम्, सेकंड द इज हर्ड, पूगद्रुमादि। देन आवाति मन्दमनिलस्सह दिव्य गन्धैः, ध इज महाप्राण हियर, शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्। देन व्हेन यू नोटिस अ हाइफन हियर लाइक यू डू in the first line, that means that both the lines have to be recited or chanted together. So take a deep breath and try to chant the entire half of the shloka, that is the first and the second pada together without taking a break, because this is actually one word. I mean, it is made up of many words, but some of you might be familiar. We call that the rule of samasa or samastapadam. Therefore, multiple words are combined according to their meaning, and we do not split while chanting that. The entire line is chanted together. Initially, while practicing, it is okay to take a breath in between if you need to. You know, you could stop maybe at the end of the first line, or I told you the words, so maybe after a word in between ends initially. But once you start practicing, this entire bit, Ishat Til Palikanam, has to be chanted together without pausing, without taking a breath in between. It will come with practice. Now we will learn this verse again. Ishat Prafulla Sarasiruhanari Kela Pugadrumadi Sumanohara Palikanam.
Ishat Prafulla Sarasiruhanari Kela Pugadrumadi Sumanohara Palikanam. Ishat Prafulla Sarasiruhanari Kela Pugadrumadi Sumanohara Palikanam.
Tamam. Avati Mandamanila Sahadivya Gandhaihi Sheshadri Shekhara Vibho Tava Suprabhatam.
Avati Mandamanila Sahadivya Gandhaihi Sheshadri Shekhara Vibho Tava Suprabhatam. Avati Mandamanila Sahadivya Gandhaihi Sheshadri Shekhara Vibho Tava Suprabhatam. Prabhatam.
Tamam. Now the entire verse. Ishat Prafulla Sarasiruhanari Kela Pugadrumadi Sumanohara Palikanam. Avati Mandamanila Sahadivya Gandhaihi Sheshadri Shekhara Vibho Tava Suprabhatam.
Ishat Prafulla Sarasiruhanari Kela Pugadrumadi Sumanohara Palikanam. Avati Mandamanila Sahadivya Gandhaihi Sheshadri Shekhara Vibho Tava Suprabhatam.
Uttamam, Shivani. So this line keeps repeating in a few verses, in the next few verses. Sheshadri Shekhara Vibho Tava Suprabhatam. It means Sheshadri Shekhara, that is referring to the Sheshadri hills, that is seven hills. Vibho, the Lord. So the Lord of seven hills. Tava, to you. Tava in Sanskritam means your, that is Shashti Vibhakti or your. Suprabhatam, like I told you yesterday, Su refers to auspiciousness or something which is Mangalakara, something which is good. Suprabhatam, may it be an auspicious morning to you. We will not go into the meaning of each verse, but just that this line is repeating again and again, we could know the meaning of this line. We move to the next verse now. Vibha.
Unmilya netra yuga muttama panjarasthaha.
Vibha.
Unmilya netra yuga muttama panjarasthaha.
once again.
Unnilya netra yugam uttam panjara.
Patra vashishta kadali phala payasani.
Patra vashishta kadali phala payasani. Patra vashishta kadali phala payasani.
Bhuktva salila matha keli shuka pathanti.
Bhuktva salila matha keli shuka pathanti. Bhuktva salila matha keli shuka pathanti.
Sheshadri Shekhar vibho tava suprabhatam.
Sheshadri Shekhar vibho tava suprabhatam. Sheshadri Shekhar vibho tava suprabhatam.
Here unmilya netra yuga muttama panjarasthaha. Tha is mahaprana. Patra vashishta kadali phala payasani. Here pha is mahaprana. So phalam refers to fruit. So if you make it palam, it has a completely different meaning. So even the meaning changes sometimes with mahaprana and alpaprana. So please note, it is phala. Here kadali phala refers to banana. So kadali phala pha, and kadali phalam, here again this pha should be pronounced as pha and not as pha. Because sometimes we see that there is a tendency to pronounce this pha as pha, because I think in Hindi it is pronounced as pha, but that is not the case in Sanskritam. We say phalam, not phalam. So please note that kadali phala payasani. Ni is a short letter, so please do not prolong that. Bhuktva, bha is mahaprana. Salila matha, tha is mahaprana. Keli shukaha pathanti. So visarga followed by pa, upadhmaniya. We do not chant the visarga completely. We chant it as keli shukaf pathanti. Here tha is mahaprana and ti is a short letter. So please do not prolong it as ti. Sheshadri shekhara vibho tava suprabhatam. I hope this is clear. Vibha, we will repeat this. Unmilya netra yugamuttama panjarasthaha patra vashishta kadali phala payasani.
Unmilya netra yugamuttama panjarasthaha patra vashishta kadali phala payasani. Unmilya netra yugamuttama panjarasthaha patra vashishta kadali phala payasani.
Bhuktva salila matha keli shuka pathanti. Sheshadri Shekhar vibho tava suprabhatam.
Bhuktva salila matha keli shukaf pathanti. Sheshadri Shekhar vibho tava suprabhatam. Bhuktva salila matha keli shukaf pathanti. Sheshadri Shekhar vibho tava suprabhatam.
Now the entire verse. Unmilya netra yugam उत्तम पंजरस्थाः पात्रावशिष्ट कदली फल पायसानि भुक्त्वा सलीलमथ केलिशुका पठन्ति शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
उन्मील्य नेत्रयुगमुत्तम पञ्जरस्थाः पात्रावशिष्ट कदली फल पायसानि भुक्त्वा सलीलमथ केलिशुकाः पठन्ति शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
Tamam, Vibha. Just one more thing to share with you all. While chanting individually, please choose any comfortable pitch. So there is no right or wrong pitch. Any Shruti you can choose. Here we are choosing a particular pitch which is comfortable for the panelists and for me to chant. But when you are chanting individually, please follow whichever Shruti, whichever pitch is most comfortable for you, which you can chant without straining your voice. But one thing to remember is to maintain consistency. So while chanting, please chant consistently in the same pitch. So it would not be advisable to change the pitch for each line or each shloka. That wouldn't be a proper way of chanting. So please maintain the same pitch in whichever you start chanting. And please start chanting aloud while practicing instead of just reading the verses in your mind. When you chant aloud, you experience the benefits of chanting, the benefits of pronouncing Sanskritam words, and it is also a very soothing exercise to chant. Next verse, Shivani.
तंत्री प्रकर्ष मधुरस्वनया
तंत्री प्रकर्ष मधुरस्वनया तंत्री प्रकर्ष मधुरस्वनया
विपंच्या
गायत्यनन्तचरितम् तव नारदोऽपि
भाषा समग्रमसकृत्करचाररम्यम्
भाषा समग्रमसकृत्करचाररम्यम्
शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम् शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्।
तमाम या तंत्री प्रकर्ष मधुरस्वनया Dhu is Mahaprana. Madhurasvanaya, there is a dvitvam. So if you hear, listen to it carefully. The way we are chanting is Madhurasvanaya. So the second S is heard before Sva. It is not Madhurasvanaya. There is a difference. Madhurasvanaya is not right. It is Madhurasvanaya. That S is heard, though it's not written here. Extra S is heard before the Sa, before Sva. That is Dvitvam. तंत्री प्रकर्ष मधुरस्वनया विपंच्या. विपंची रेफर्स टू द वीणा. गायति अनंत चरितम तव. हियर गायति अनंत चरितम. Narada is singing the glory of Bhagavan. That is what is being referred to here. Gayatyananta charitam tava. You could either chant it as Ananta charitam tava or combine the sandhi and chant it as Gayatyananta charitam tava. That is also correct. Optional rule of combining the sandhi. Ananta charitam tava. That is also correct. Naradopi. Now here you have a S like symbol after Narado before P. This is what we call an Avagraha Chinha. That refers to Purva Rupa Sandhi in Sanskritam. While combining these two words, Naradaha Api, when you split, we get Naradaha Api. That becomes Narado and Api. And instead of the A, you get an Avagraha Chinha. So that just denotes that it is a Purva Rupa Sandhi. You might come across this in many other verses. Those who learnt Gita will be very familiar. In many verses, we came across this. Please note that we do not chant this particular sign. It is just there. So while chanting, we just chant it as Naradopi. There is no need to recite or chant that sign. But it is there to denote a particular Sandhi in Sanskritam because of the Sandhi rule. Please remember this because we get many questions. Why is there an S-like symbol there? So it just denotes that there is a sandhi there. Naradopi. P is a short letter. So please do not prolong it. Bhasha samagramasakritkara chara ramyam. Bha is Mahaprana. This entire pada, entire quarter is chanted together. Bhasha samagramasakritkara chara ramyam. So no pausing in between. Sheshadrishekhara vibho tava suprabhatam. We will repeat this. Shivani. Tantri prakarsha madhurasvanaya vipanchya gayatyananta charitantava naradopi.
त्री प्रकर्ष मधुरस्वनया विपंच्या गायत्यनंत चरितं तव नारदोपि. तंत्री प्रकर्ष मधुरस्वनया विपंच्या गायत्यनंत चरितं तव नारदोपि.
भाषा समग्रमसकृत्करचाररम्यं शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्.
भाषा समग्रमसकृत्करचाररम्यं शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्. भाषा समग्रमसकृत्करचाररम्यं शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्.
तमाम. नाउ द एंटायर वर्स. तंत्री प्रकर्ष मधुरस्वनया विपंच्या गायत्यनंत चरितं तव नारदोपि. भाषा समग्रमसकृत्करचाररम्यं शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्.
तंत्री प्रकर्ष मधुरस्वनया विपंच्या गायत्यनंत चरितं तव नारदोपि. भाषा समग्रमसकृत्करचाररम्यं शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्.
तमाम. शिवानी. वी विल have a quick recap of whatever we have learned in today's class, that is verses 4 to 9.
Tav suprabhatam aravindalochane bhavatu prasanna mukha chandra mandale vidhi shankarendra vanita bhirarchite vrisha shailanath dayite dayanidhe atryadi saptarshayas samupasya sandhyam आकाश सिंधु कमलानि मनोहराणि आदाय पादयुगमर्चयितुं प्रपन्नाः शेषाद्रि शेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम् पञ्चाननाब्ज भव षण्मुखवासवाद्याः त्रैविक क्रमादि चरितं विबुधास्तु वन्ति भाषापति पठति वासर शुद्धि मारात शेषाद्रि शेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम् ईषत् प्रफुल्ल सरसीरुह नारिकेल पूगद्रुमादि सुमनोहर पालिकानाम् आवाति मन्दमनिलः सह दिव्यगन्धैः शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम् उन्मील्य नेत्रयुगमुत्तम पञ्जरस्थाः पात्रावशिष्टकदलीफलपायसानि भुक्त्वा सलीलमथ केलिशुकाः पठन्ति शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम् तन्त्री प्रकर्षमधुरस्वनया विपञ्च्या गायत्यनन्तचरितं तव नारदोऽपि भाषा समग्रमसकृत्करचाररम्यम् शेषाद्रिशेखर विभो तव सुप्रभातम्
सो दीज आर द वर्सेस फॉर टुडे प्लीज प्रैक्टिस एंड टुमारो वी विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम द 10th वर्स ऑनवर्ड सो वी विल फॉलो दिस वी विल कीप रिवाइजिंग व्हाटएवर वी हैव लर्नड इन द प्रीवियस क्लास Learn the new verses, then also revise the verses, whatever we have learned in that class, so that it would help you practice better. Any questions, you could please send me an email. I believe that the chat has been disabled. Those who want to ask me anything, we have, we have already run out of time, but anyway, Shubha Bhagini. Shubha Bhagini, please unmute.
Ram Ram Bhagini.
Ram Ram.
So Suprabhatam is supposed to be chanted in the morning. Now when we have to practice during the day, is there any chant that we need, any verse that we need to chant before we start practicing this?
That is a good question, Bhagini. I'm not aware of any verse which you will have to chant before that, but I will find out and get back to you on this.
So okay. We could practice this during any time of the day.
I will find out about that also from my gurus and tell you.
Sure.
Because I am not aware, like you said, yes, we practice it in the morning hours. So if you're able to practice in the morning, that would be great. Generally, it is a practice not to chant Suprabhatam later because it is for... waking up Bhagavan. Suprabhatam is auspicious morning, but I will find out if for practice reasons you could practice later or if there's any verse which you can chant.
Dhanyavad Bhagini.
Mohana Valambe Bhagini, please unmute. And once you finish asking your question, please lower your hand. Mohana Valambe Bhagini. Okay.
Brindavagini.
Namaste Deepankar Mahodaya.
You have to click on ask to unmute button to unmute everybody. Or the selected one.
Yes. Okay. Haan. Yes, Mohana Valambe Bhagini. Unable to hear you. You're on mute.
Yes, got it. Bhagini, I had the same problem. We people in the US, it is 8:45 at night. My mother would have a heart attack if I do suprabhatam like this. She's sitting behind me. So I'm kind of... that's why yesterday I didn't join the class.
Okay.
So you got to give us some...
I will find out from my gurus and scholars and try to give you an answer.
This is very important for us, people like me who want to learn.
Yes.
If I skip this and do it on the YouTube, it's not the same, Bhagini. Okay?
I understand.
Thank you. Dhanyabadha,
Shubharatri. For you, Shubharatrihi. For others, Suprabhatam, who are in India. Now, Chanchal Vadhva, Bhagini. Please unmute. Also, Deepankar Mahodaya, is there any way they can ask questions on this platform like we have in GoToWebinar? Because there are many who have raised hands and I'm sorry, we won't have time to take all of them.
Ram, 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 Bhagni ji, I think my question is same because I'm in Canada and it is night here. So I would like to know what is the right time to do. Thank you so much.
Yes, I will get back to you on this, Bhagini. Thank you. Deepankar Mahodaya, if you're here, please let us know if there is any way they can ask questions other than raising hand and speaking because we have run out of time.
Yes.
If they can send us and if we can reply, that might be easier. Otherwise, I won't be able to take all of them.
Yes, Bhagini. There are no other ways except the chat for now.
Okay.
As of now, we only have this. Either you can raise your hands or you can send your chat, which for now enabled only to the host. Whatever you might send from your end, it will only reach to the host and it will not reach to other participants. The rest is like this. You can only use a chat or you can raise your hands for now.
That is a good option, Deepankar Mahodaya. Thank you. So those who want to ask me questions can send me on chat also. Just your questions, please. And I will be able to see the chat messages and others won't get disrupted.
Yes.
Okay, one question. Panchananabja bhava shanmukha vasavadyaha. Vasavadyaha, there is no mahaprana there. Here, shanmukha vasavadyaha, only shanmukha, kha is mahaprana. Next, after that, there are no mahapranas. Shanmukha vasavadyaha. In the sense, like I said, I mean, even sha, sa, and ha are mahapranaha. Because you require more breath to chant sha, sha, sa, and ha compared to the alpa prana letters. So going by that rule, sa would be a mahaprana, but I'm not highlighting the mahapranas in avargiya vyanjanani. So shanmukha vasavadyaha. Sa is a mahaprana letter as per the rules of Sanskritam grammar, but I am not highlighting those. I'm only differentiating ka, kha, ga, gha, those letters like we come across in the Vargiya Vyanjanani. That is the first and the third letter, second and the fourth letter of each Varga. So I only highlight second and fourth letters of each Varga. I wouldn't be highlighting sha, sha, saha everywhere. Though by rules, they are Mahaprana letters only. Okay. Bhasha Pati Pathati. Is there an F sound? So like I said, Bhasha Patihi Pathati. Visarga followed by pa is what we call upadhmaniya. We wouldn't say it is F sound. What is actually happening is we are expelling the air and closing the mouth immediately. So that is the kind of pronunciation for upadhmaniya. So bhasha pati pathati. That is what is supposed to be done But sometimes while some of us pronounce, F might be heard by because of the way we pronounce Upadhmaniya. But the rule is not that it should be F. There is no, it's not that it should be replaced by F. That is not the rule. Just the rule is that whenever Visarga is followed by Pa, we expel the air and close the lips immediately. So that is the kind of exercise or pronunciation for Upadhmaniya. I hope that is clear. Oh, repeating thrice might be, I'm answering the questions in the chat now. Repeating thrice might be a little time consuming. Okay, so what we could do is maybe we could repeat the entire verse twice. I could request the panelist to repeat the entire verse twice. That might be helpful instead of repeating each line thrice. That will be very time consuming. Will there be individual chanting? Yes, we will start individual chanting soon, subject to time, of course. So maybe after I finish teaching on a few days, we can learn few verses and give you time to chant individually. Who has written Suprabhatam? Yesterday, we answered this question. It is written by Prativadi Bhayankara Anantacharya, or famously known as Prativadi Bhayankara Annan. Prativadi means opponent in Vagvada or opponent in arguments. So the others used to be scared of arguing with him because of his knowledge and his expertise. So he's called Prativadi Bhayankara, Anantacharya or Annan. Do we need to extend Dirgha when there is Avagraha Chinha? It is not Navagraha symbol. Please note, Jayashree Bhagini, it is not Navagraha, it is Avagraha, not Na. Avagraha Chinha, no, there is no need to extend. There is no Dirgha. You just please, while chanting, you don't have to bother about Avagraha Chinha. Please note that, say, Naradopi, it means Narado Api. There is an instead of a, we get the Avagraha Chinha, but there is no need to extend. Narado by itself is a Dirgha. Like I told you, O is a Dirgha in Sanskritam. Therefore, Narado, not because of the Avagraha Chinha. Avagraha Chinha, there's no need to extend or chant it as Dirgha. Ha, Prasad Mahodayaha. So, Daiva Manhikam, I referred to this yesterday also. There are certain words in Sanskritam like Madhyanhaha, here Daiva Manhikam, Brahma, Janhavi, Prahladaha, Jihva, like you have, not really Jihva, but Prahladaha, Janhavi, and Brahma, which is very commonly used, where though we write it as Braha and Ma, we pronounce it as Brahma. Similarly, Janhavi, though we write it as Ja, Ha, and Na, we pronounce it as Janhavi. Now, these are certain practices which have been followed, and also as per the rules of Shiksha Shastram, this is how this has been, these words have been pronounced in that way itself. So, these are certain exceptions to where we pronounce in a particular way, though we write slightly differently. And these have to be followed. Like I said yesterday, there is an alternative school, which some of them are following, which says that we just pronounce the way it is written. But we do not belong to that school. In all our chanting courses, we chant it as Brahma, Janhavi, Daiva Manhikam, Madhyanhaha only. I'm repeating it. I said yesterday also, we are not getting into the debate as to which is right and which is wrong. Both schools are there, but the more accepted one and the one which we follow from our gurus is this one. Daiva Manhikam Brahma. That is what we follow. Break the compound words. Can we break the compound word for learning? Yes. You could. Please note where you want to take a breath. You could start learning that way. But once you learn, please chant completely, because we are not supposed to pause in between while chanting. Divya Murte, is there a dvitvam? Divya, there is a dvitvam. Yes, D and V. Before V, there is dvitvam. easy way to identify dvitvams, it comes with practice. If you all want, I could direct you to one particular YouTube recording where Dr. Soumya Bhagini has dealt with dvitvam very much in detail, referring to Panini's sutras. But it is really, I mean, you need to know Sanskritam grammar for that. And it is in Sanskritam. So if you're able to follow that, then I will request her for the link and share the video with you. But you will have to have a bit of background in grammar and other things to understand that video. But let's see if we can do a simpler one and share it. Bhasha patihi, visarga is not silent. It is it is what I said. It's an upadhmaniya. Bhasha patih pathati. Whenever a visarga is followed by pa or pa, then we get what we call an upadhmaniya. So therefore, please chant it, remembering that rule. So whenever visarga is followed by pa or pa, please remember it is upadhmaniya. Bhasha patih pathati. Any more questions, please type it on the chat to me, because we don't have time. It is already 7. We are 15 minutes past the time. You could either send me an email or you could please type it out in the chat tomorrow. I'm very sorry if I take all questions. This will go on for another hour or so. So we should try to keep up the time, as everyone will have other commitments too. So please send me the questions on email, or you could send me on chat tomorrow. Let us conclude with Shanti Mantra. Huh? सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः Sarvebhyaha dhanyavadaha. Thank you so much for attending. We shall meet tomorrow at the same time, that is 5:45 a.m. Indian time. Thank you. Dhanyavadaha.